Hey everybody, Lance here. We're talking about the lats and the chin-up today. So if you watch our previous videos, we talked about the lats in the horizontal row. We talked about the lats in the pull-up. And now today, to get on the same term here, we're talking about the chin-up, the underhand grip variation of this. So what changes? Well, if you watch the pull-up video, you know I get more lat activation if my arms are in that frontal plane of my body. They're in that jumping jack plane of my body. With the chin up, I can't do that, right? I can't get my elbows out to my sides. They stay tucked in like this. And so I shift some of the force off of the lat, though they are still a primary mover of this exercise. I shift some of the force off of them and I can put it onto my bicep. That's why people generally feel a lot stronger in this area. I'm using a broader subset of muscles. I have more muscle fibers going on here. I would say that the numbers aren't really that much different because I do limit the lat a little bit. I do recruit more upper arm. So like if you're looking to build bicep, you can get it with the pull-up variation, but I would also consider doing the chin-up variation because I think you're gonna stress those upper arm muscles a little bit more. The other thing that I want to talk about is not only do we shift the force onto the bicep, but we shift the force onto the pec even, because the pec is now gaining a little bit more leverage as the elbows come in here. They're still involved in the pull-up. They still bring my arms down to at least here. And they're going to keep going, right? Because I start to bring my arms in. I'm thinking through this with you. So pec is normal, but I don't want that to be your primary pulling muscle, right? When I do that, so the pec also pulls my shoulder forward. And if I'm pulling the shoulder forward, I'm messing up some of the mechanics of the shoulder. I'm not getting the humerus bone to glide in the shoulder blade socket very well. So that's definitely too much about the lats during the chin up. Keep it in mind, like if your goal is to train lats, you probably want to stick with some of the more overhead or overhand variations, but you can still throw in some of the underhand variations, especially if upper arm size is a goal as well.